Hello, my name is Adis Pradhan and I'm just starting the online classes for all the Madhyamik students so that it will be helpful for you during this lockdown period. So we are starting our lesson from trigonometry. I have divided this trigonometry into many lessons. So this is going to be our first lesson. I'll just give the introduction of the trigonometry, what is trigonometry and what are the kind of things you learn in trigonometry. So let's start our class. So if I have to tell something about trigonometry, what trigonometry is. In trigonometry, what you do is, you study the right angle triangle. You'll only study the right angle triangle. So why only this right angle triangle? It's because of this Pythagoras theorem. So first, before studying Pythagoras theorem, so let's have a look at this right angle triangle. So what is right angle triangle? A triangle in which one of the angle is 90 degree is called right angle triangle, and the side in front of this 90 degree is called hypotenuse. So the side which is in front of 90 degree is hypotenuse, and other two sides are called base and perpendicular. It depends on the situation, which side will be the base or which side will be the perpendicular. We'll discuss it later. So for now, we'll begin with Pythagoras theorem. Why this trigonometry, that is study of right angle triangle, why we are specially focusing on this right angle triangle? It's because of this Pythagoras theorem. And this Pythagoras theorem is h squared equals to p squared plus b squared. And where this Pythagoras theorem is useful. So I will go to the next slide. So look here. And this first triangle, you know this side is 3, this side is 4, and this side you don't know what is the side. So Pythagoras theorem will help us to find out the side of the triangle. That is, if you know the two sides of the triangle, then you can find out the another side of the triangle using this formula. So you have P here, you have B here, you don't know the hypotenuse. So what you are going to do is, you'll put the value of P and B in this formula. 3 squared is 9, 4 squared is 16. Add this 2, you'll get 25. 8 squared equals to 25. Take this square this side, it will become square root. So square root of 25 is 5. So you are able to find the hypotenuse using this two side and the formula which is given by our Pythagoras. Similarly, you can find out the perpendicular or the base if other two sides are given. So another thing is, how to determine which side is perpendicular or which side is base. If you go to the first slide, and if you look here, then I have written perpendicular and base this side also, perpendicular and base this side also, because it depends on the situation or the angle which you are looking at. If you are looking at this angle, then the side in front of it, this, that is this side, that is this side is called perpendicular. And if you are looking at this angle, then the side in front of this will be called perpendicular and other side will be called base. Now look at this figure. Okay, we'll go to the another topic. Let's just look at this figure. So this is also right angle triangle, right angle triangle, all of them are right angle triangle. So the size of them are increasing, but the angle is same, 30 degree, 30 degree, 30 degree and 30 degree. So in this type of situation, if you divide perpendicular by hypotenuse, if you get 1 by 2 for this triangle, then you will get 1 by 2 for this triangle, this triangle, this triangle, this triangle. It means that the ratio of the side of a triangle, right angle triangle, it does not depend on the size of the right angle triangle. It only depends on the angle which you are looking at. So now, to study trigonometry, what is important is you have to study the ratio of the side of right angle triangle. So we'll find some ratios by making some combination here. So you can divide perpendicular by hypotenuse, base by hypotenuse, P by base, that is perpendicular by base, and you are giving some name to it. If you are dividing perpendicular by hypotenuse, you are calling it sine, this is cos, and this is tan. And if you take the reciprocal of this one, you'll get cos sec, reciprocal of this one sec, and reciprocal of this one is cot. If you want to continue further in trigonometry, you have to remember this. That is, if someone asks you what is cos, then you have to tell this base by hypotenuse. You have to remember this to move forward in trigonometry. But how to remember this? It will not be easy to remember this without this mnemonics. So if you use this mnemonics, then it will help you to remember this one. Suppose, see here, some people have curly brown hair, turn permanently black. So if you want to know what sign is, just use the first letters of this word. So first letter is S, P and H. This is like some people have curly brown hair, turn permanently black. So cos sec you can find by reversing it, so no problem for other ratios. That is, sec is opposite of this one and cot is opposite of this one. So I hope you have got some idea about the trigonometry now. So this is the assignment for you, which you can do and submit me in this WhatsApp number, or you can email it in this email, or you can either use the Google Classroom for further information. So thank you. I will meet in next class.